In my research, I quantify human motion and human-machine interactions so that we can make evidence-based decisions. For example, I put wearable sensors on the body, and then I can create direct measures of human performance that are typically qualitative, like agility. And then I can examine technologies like spacesuits or exoskeletons and start to see how they actually affect our performance in a quantitative way. So human augmentation is a purposeful modification of the body or the mind in order to affect a change in performance or behavior or appearance. I think it's important for scientists to be talking about human augmentation because there's a lot of really interesting challenges in augmentation and a lot of ethical questions that shouldn't just be decided by policymakers or just be decided by scientists, but should be brought up to our community at large. My research is relevant to the field of human augmentation because I work on how we can create measures of performance, and for augmentation and augmentation technologies, we need to understand how they affect behavior in an evidence-based way, and I provide ways to look at that evidence in a quantified manner. One of the things that I do with public engagement is getting involved with K-12 education, and recently I've done a project with the MIT Museum where we worked on creating prompts for teachers to use within their class. These prompts were actually specifically related to quantifying motion and human augmentation. The teachers actually took these prompts back to their classrooms, and these were classrooms around the world. And it was amazing to see actually all the different projects that they created and just the way that a simple prompt could lead to so many different unique solutions. With this fellowship, I really wanted the opportunity to learn how to engage in new ways and to practice things that I hadn't done before, such as video interviews or engaging with Reddit or Twitter and those kinds of activities.